to another Animal Crossing New Horizons video. So as you can see in today's video, we're playing very early in the morning. I wanted to make a really relaxing and cozy 5 a.m. video. The 5 a.m. soundtrack in New Horizons is probably the best, in my opinion. Ooh, there's some bugs. Do I have a net on me? Oh no, I don't even have a net, so I'll have to craft one of those at some point because the shop won't be open at this time of day. But today we're just going to be collecting acorns and pine cones because I don't have many of those. I thought it would be fun if we just went around my island and collected some acorns together. If you didn't know, you need acorns in this game to craft a lot of the seasonal furniture, which I actually don't have. You may have seen in my last speed build video, I did an animal fairy speed build and I used a lot of autumn furniture. I actually just asked someone in my Discord server if I could catalog their furniture. I don't actually own like any of that furniture myself. So today I'm going to be collecting acorns and pine cones to hopefully be able to craft more of that furniture. So I don't know if the last time you saw my island it had this little bridge, but yeah, I actually changed my bridge here. I don't think I had a bridge here originally. Oh no, I did, but it was very straight, so I made it a diagonal bridge. And I really love that spot where you can see the moon in the background. I kind of wish the grass color was orange, though I really like this green color as well. Here's Fang's house. I haven't shown you Fang's house on here, but I have shown my patrons and everyone on my Instagram. Sorry if you can hear Archie running around the living room. He's always doing that recently when I record. But I really like the way Fang's house came out. I won't do a complete island tour yet. If you want to see like my island up close in more detail, I will do an island tour or an island update at some point, but that's not what we're doing today, though you can basically see everything that is on my island at the moment. I'm going to be cleaning up my island too while we do this because there's a lot of weeds where I haven't played in a long time. I can't even remember the last time I played this game properly. Why don't we sleep here on the rose for a little while? Look how cozy this is at 5 a.m. It's so lovely. I hardly ever play at this time of day, especially on YouTube. Okay, so I need 5 branches to craft a net. That should be easy enough because we're going to be looking for acorns anyway. We're bound to find a lot of tree branches. So let's get shaking the trees. Ooh, I got some money. Find a penny, pick it up. All the day, have good luck. So hopefully we'll find a lot of acorns today. Ooh, a pine cone. Yay. I love that they added pine cones in this game. I think it's such a great addition to Animal Crossing. I wish we could do more with them. If you didn't know, in Animal Crossing Wild World, the reason we collected mushrooms was to craft mush furniture. And there was like a whole event with Tortoma, who would have an acorn as a head and you'd call him Cornoma. He's an NPC I really miss from the old games. I hope one day they'll bring him back. I think he was an amazing character and his event was so much fun. Yeah, I'd really love us to be able to do more with these items like the pine cones and the acorns and the mushrooms as well, though the mushrooms aren't available yet. I might make another video just like this once the mushrooms are available because I still need to collect a lot of the mushroom furniture as well and it'd be really useful for my fairycore island. Okay, so I think we have enough sticks now, so we can probably craft a net and then start catching some bugs while we're exploring the island too. My friend Gab told me this tip of just carrying the crafting table around with you all the time so you can just craft wherever you are, which is so smart. I don't know why I never thought of that before she told me. But yeah, I always carry my crafting table around with me now. Don't ask me why I never thought of that. Okay, so I wanted to catch that stink bug, the one that looks like an uncle or something. I think it was on this flower. Okay, I did catch something. Okay, I got it. A man-faced stink bug reminds me of my uncle. When Animal Crossing first came out, I caught so many of these, like because I got a lot of hybrid flowers from a Nook Mile island when they used to be hybrid flower islands, which they've removed from the game now, which sucks. I planted loads of flowers on my island and they just spawned those man-faced stink bugs like crazy, and they were worth more when the game first came out as well, so that's how I made all my money. I would just walk around at around nighttime and catch loads of them. We got an acorn! Yay! The majestic acorn. Oh yay, I'm so happy. I didn't actually play that much at this time of year last year. I can't remember why, but I just didn't play as much Animal Crossing as I usually would, I guess. So I have like hardly any of these autumn recipes. And I have hardly any of the mushroom recipes as well. So hopefully we can collect some materials today and I'll be able to craft some more of those items eventually. So why don't we head into our fairy forest and see if there's any we can find in here. Everything looks so lovely at this time of day. Oh, there's some money in the floor there we can dig up. Let me catch this butterfly first. There's so many bugs out at this time of day. There's never usually this many bugs out on my island. a bell cricket. You can sell these for some bells later. And yeah, I know you're supposed to bury these to make money trees. I have played all the Animal Crossing games, so I am aware of that before anyone tells me. I just want the bells quickly, and I don't want to plant a tree there, so I'm not going to do that. Over here is my great big fairy tree. I love the music that's playing here, and I love to just sit here. I thought that 5 a.m. would be more prettier, but I think we have, unfortunately, started playing on a cloudy day, which really sucks because I thought it was going to be all bright and beautiful. But it's so lovely just sitting here under the tree. It looks the best in springtime. It doesn't look as magical at this time of year, unfortunately. Yay, the fairy tree gave us another acorn! Yes! So, I know it's been a very long time since I filmed an actual New Horizons Let's Play video, and honestly, I think it's very obvious the reason why. There is not much to do in this game at the moment. It's really peaceful and lovely, of course. Like, I love playing at this time of day and just walking around, and it's really nice. But there really is nothing, and it feels like I've been waiting for them to add something for me to do for so long, and nothing's changed. Oh my goodness, look at all these butterflies! Let's catch these, they're so pretty! Yay! I caught a monarch butterfly. Guess the butterflies are a democracy now. Let's get this second one and then hopefully, eventually we can find a third one. And then we can give those to Flick and I can get a model of this butterfly. I do already have a model, but I want like tons of butterfly models all around my island. So hopefully we can catch a third one. Again, I didn't realize so many bugs would be out at this time of day. So we got some Nook Miles, we have exactly 12,000 now, that's really satisfying for some reason. It's so dark, I didn't expect it to be this dark at 5 a.m. Let's give this tree a shake. Doesn't look like we're getting anything. Oh, we did, we got a pinecone! Yay! I think last year I did manage to get a couple, like quite a few pinecones, but I really struggled to find any acorns. And I didn't unlock like hardly any recipes either. I have managed to find more recipes since, like friends have gifted me some and stuff like that, but I still don't think I have all the recipes, and I definitely don't have like hardly any of the items. Look how dark and gloomy the sky is. I thought it was going to be so bright and beautiful at 5 a.m. Oh, it's so unfortunate. I thought today was going to be really lovely in the game, but it's really gloomy. Oh well, it still has its own little autumn vibe. It's been so sunny here in the UK, it's kind of nice to see some gloom in a video game. Do you guys like my tiny little apple orchard? I put this little gnome here and like you can weigh the apples you need and make some apple juice or apple pie. It's just like a really tiny little area, but I really like how it came out. Oh, I didn't mean to pick up those flowers. I have to go to Nook's Cranny and sell these, but let's catch this last monarch butterfly first. Yay, so now we can keep these and give them to Flick. I'm going to store them here for now because I don't think Flick is here today. So I'll just put them under this tree. Okay, so let's sell these in the drop-off box. I don't need those or these bugs. Oh, I don't want to accidentally sell my acorns. That would be bad. I don't need my weeds or my sticks either. So let's sell those. Okay, so let's carry on shaking the trees. Oh, we got a furniture piece this time. A judge's bell. I can't actually remember what this item looks like. Let's have a look. Oh, I thought it was this one. Oh my goodness, it's so loud. I love it. I'm not sure what I'd ever use this for though. Okay, I should stop pressing the button now because it's really noisy. Here's my little picnic area. Oh, there's a present. Do I have a slingshot? No, I don't. What do I need to craft one? Hardwood. Oh, I can't be bothered to go back to my house and see if I have any. Never mind. Just twigs again. Let's head down here towards the right. I know there's a lot of weeds over here I need to pluck. So let's get rid of these. I'm still working on these areas. If it wasn't obvious, they're still very messy. But I have changed them quite a bit since I think the last time you guys saw them. So let's give these trees a shake. Let me know in the comments, guys, what you're up to today. Let me know if you've been playing any Animal Crossing lately. I feel like a lot of people have fallen off the game now and aren't playing it as much. I think once we get a new update, some players will come back. But I know actually of a lot of people that just stopped playing like within the first year and got really bored, which honestly I'm not that surprised by, because there was a lot of new players brought to Animal Crossing who probably got very into it and then fell off because they aren't like super fans, you know? And there's not really much to do in this game compared to the old games. There's like It's really fun for decorating, I think, but the decorating is a lot of work and it can be really tiring, and it's very easy to compare your island to other people's you see on the internet, and it can make it feel not as fun anymore. And it's a very different Animal Crossing vibe to the old games. The old games was very much like, let's relax and make friends and just enjoy relaxing and having a nice day. Oh, we got some more money! Yay! But in this new game, it's sort of like, let's decorate, and that's kind of it. So there are events, and obviously your villagers do speak to you, but it's really not the main thing anymore. And so it is a very different experience. Oh my goodness, there's someone in our campsite! So here's what my campsite looks like. I'm really excited. I haven't done one of these in ages, so I guess let's head into the tent and see which villager is visiting us today. I'm so excited to find out who it is. Let's go! Oh my goodness, it's Dina! Oh my gosh, she's so cute! Hi, are you a resident? Seems like a great place to live, woo woo! I didn't know that was her catchphrase. Oh my gosh, she's so cute! Where are my manners? Sorry, my name's Dina. You're so lucky to live here. I know I want to make the most of my visit. I love her little rosy cheeks. I love Animal Crossing villages with simple designs like this. I just think they're so adorable. Look at her. She's so cute. I don't think she's a very popular villager, but I love her. I think she is adorable. I've actually never had her, but her design is so cute to me. She has such round eyes and cute little cheeks. So I've got a fun idea. Want to play a game? If you win, then you get my sweater on shirt. What do you think, Woo Woo? Okay, let's play. I'll shuffle the cards. That animation's so cute. Okay, does the card I just drew have a red or black symbol? Which is it, Woo Woo? I was thinking red, but I think I'm gonna second guess myself and go for black. That's your guess? Let's find out. Oh no! Oh, that's a red one. You didn't guess right. That card is so cute though. I'm sorry, looks like you don't win a prize this time around. Don't let this discourage you from playing with me again sometime. Okay, well that's a shame. Never mind, I guess. The real prize was getting to see such a cute little ducky villager. Okay, let's head back outside and look for acorns. That was such a nice surprise. I've had quite good luck with the villagers recently. If you follow me on Instagram, you would have seen that I had Lily turn up in my campsite, and I was so excited because Lily's such an adorable villager and honestly one I would really happily have on my island, but I just don't have any space, unfortunately. But I really like Lily, and she's one villager that I don't think I have any specific memories with, but she's such a classic villager that I think a lot of people love. Oh my goodness, look who's here! It's Gulliver! Yum yum yum. Wake up, Gulliver. Or am I gonna have to use my net? Arr, Buccaneer. That's a bit out of my price range. Could I talk you into a discount for both ears? Okay, well if you're not gonna wake up, I'm gonna have to hit you. Boink. Yo-ho, yo-ho. Pirate sounds, etc. You're still not gonna wake up. Wake up. Oh, here we go. Gah! What happened? Where am I? Who are you? Why am I dressed like this? Wait. It's all coming back to me. You be Loulou, of course. Arr, I think the cage was rattled pretty bad that time. I'm feeling a wee bit bird-brained. Do you get it? Because I be a bird. Ha ha, arr, I quack me up. Kidding aside, I fell overboard again. You probably guessed as much. I'll contact the crew straight away. So long as I've got my trusty old communicator, I'll be just... Oh my gosh! My trusty communicator has gone vanished. Arr! Those waves brought me around like an inflatable beach ball. The thing must have slipped out of my pocket. That means I'm lost at sea. I'll have to wait for my buccaneer buddies to find me on their own. That could take quite a bit of time. I'm still workshopping my pirate puns, so those are sure to run out fast. Ahoy! You with the whale-sized noggin. Hey! You have the same size head, excuse me. Of course I'll help you. Well, you're even sweeter than the famous Captain Syrup, but without her double crossing, I hope. That means it's up to you to swim about and find my communicator. I'm counting on you, matey. Okay, Gulliver. Well, I don't actually have my swimming costume on me, so let me go grab that and then we can get swimming. I'm also thinking after this, I might change the date because I really wanted it to be super pretty 5 a.m. but unfortunately I've started playing on a really cloudy day. So let's go swimming, find Gulliver's thing, and then let's change the date to a more bright and sunny day. Okay, let's head in. It's so weird swimming at this time of day. I hardly ever swim in Animal Crossing anymore. I used to do it a lot in New Leaf. I hardly ever do it in New Horizons. So I'm missing like a ton of sea creatures from my collection. But I mean, especially it's weird at this time of day, like how dark and eerie the sea is. Can you imagine swimming in the sea when it's this dark? Okay, I think we found something. Yay, we got it, and it matches our outfit too. Okay, well he's right there, so that shouldn't take long. I actually really like Gulliver. I mean, I wish we had a different NPC rather than just Gulliver twice, but I think he's super cute dressed as a pirate. Arr, have you found it yet? Yar. Arr, that's it. That's my precious communicator. Yay! I thank you with all my heart, matey. Put extra cherries on top even. Now I can contact my faithful crew. You saved my life. That's the debt that needs repaying, so I'll ship you a fine reward soon. Expedited. Arr. Ah, that takes a load off. Nothing left to do but wander this here beach and look mean. Here I go. Arr. Okay, so now that we've finished Gulliver's quest, look how gloomy this sky is. I can't continue to look for acorns in a sky like this. So I'm going to change the date to tomorrow and then I'll be right back and we can carry on collecting acorns. So I'll see you in a minute. Okay, so here we are and everything is so much prettier. I hadn't actually played at 5 a.m. when it's that gloomy before. Every single time I've played at 5 a.m. it's been so beautiful like this. So I was really confused actually when it was so gloomy. I assume it was going to rain at 6 a.m. or something and that's why. But anyways, it's so beautiful. Now we can carry on looking for acorns and pine cones, of course. A lot of my trees are just surrounded by flowers or bushes or items. So I don't actually have that many trees that I can shake and hope to get things out of. Let's pluck these weeds up here and then we get a really good view of the sunrise. Look how beautiful that is. Isn't that so lovely? Wow. I just think those little islands in the distance are probably all of you and your islands. It's so cute. Oh, all we're getting is twigs. Do you guys like my little fairy circle? It's inspired by Tinkerbell, of course. If you know Tinkerbell movies, you probably recognize it straight away. I hope you guys like it. I love it. But it's okay if you don't. Like, I think in my last New Horizons Let's Play video, I had someone... I think I was talking about a hate comment I got that someone said my island was ugly. I just think that's a really weird comment to leave because it's like... It's not your island. Why do you care how someone else decorates their imaginary island on their game? On their literal video game? Like, why would you be upset about how someone chooses to decorate something in their own game? It's so weird. Sometimes people just get offended or angry about the weirdest things and I have no idea. Like, if you think something's ugly, don't just tell them. Like, I could have responded, "You're ugly," but I didn't. Because it's not a nice thing to do. I just don't understand some people. But yeah, if you don't like my island, that's fine. It's not yours, so you don't have to like it. To be honest, I hardly ever feel confident about my own island. It's such a mess, and I just never have the energy to work on it. But I think it's coming along okay, but I really haven't done any work on it in a long time. So it's kind of difficult. I felt like I was getting really close to finishing my island, honestly, around springtime. And then it started changing to autumn and I realized all my designs don't look very good in autumn. And so I've been changing my pathways and it's been a whole ordeal because the thing is with Animal Crossing and pathways, the grass is always changing and it's really difficult to find a pathway that's just gonna look good all year round. Especially because I went with a lot of spring core pathways, like the grass pathways. So it's just been really messy trying to do that. Here's my little wedding bell. I decided to put this right in front of the museum. I think it looks super cute. I really wanted this item for my island and I think it suits it really well. I'm not sure if I'll keep it surrounded by hedges, but I think it looks okay for now. We don't seem to be getting any pine cones or acorns at the moment. I wonder if we've got too many. Tulip, long time no see. You must have been really busy lately. Feels like ages since you've talked. She's so cute wearing my heart jumper design. It has been a long time since I've chatted to Melba. Oh, we got another piece of furniture. Excuse me, Melba. Thank you. She's so cute. Oh, sewing machine. Awesome. How comes all we're getting is twigs? Do you think the game knows that I time traveled and it's punishing me? I think it might, you know. That's actually something else that I do a lot in New Horizons is time travel. Oh my goodness, look at all these butterflies in the same place. That's so beautiful. I've never seen so many in one place like that before. But yeah, that's something I do quite often in New Horizons is time travel, and I hardly ever time traveled in the old games. Like, I don't think I ever did. Like, obviously, I know I did, like, sometimes, but it was very, very rarely. But in New Horizons, I just time travel all the time because I don't really get punished for it because Rossetti's not around anymore. And there's not much to do other than decorating. And decorating without time traveling can be really, really annoying sometimes. Oh my goodness. Quick, 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 quick. Do you think I can make it to the town hall? Oh my goodness, Kiki Slider's in the way. Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. Okay, we did it. Okay, thank goodness we didn't get bit by bees. I was literally just thinking, I haven't been bitten by bees this entire episode. Look how cute those little birds are. Shout out to them. I haven't checked my notice board in months just because I like looking at those little birds because they're so cute. They have the cutest little podgy faces. I love them so much. And at nighttime, there's owls there as well. They're so adorable. They look so fluffy. I love them so much. I'm really not getting anything. I'm so confused. I'm literally not even getting anything now. What is going on? I suppose let's try the big fairy tree again. Maybe we'll get some luck with this one. Twigs, twigs, twigs. Are you kidding me? More twigs? Why is it so difficult to find acorns in this game? I don't understand. Oh, I actually have quite a few blue flowers that have grown over here. I didn't mean for that to happen. Okay, so we've got our little picnic basket. Let's pretend the whole basket is full of pine cones and acorns. This really makes me want to go outside in real life and go collect them. I remember last autumn, I went to this woodland animal place. It was like a zoo. It's like a zoo, but not really. Well, I suppose it is, but it's like a woodland with animals in. And there was deers and stuff. And I went there last autumn and I collected acorns and it was so much fun. I hope I get to do something like that again this year. Oh my goodness, we got an acorn! Yes! It feels like it's been so long since I got one. Yay! So happy. And we got another one. Oh my goodness, we are so lucky. This tree is magical. This is my new favorite tree. Thank you, Mr. Tree. I love you. I'm never moving this tree ever. And this is actually an area I was working on recently. Again, if you followed me on Instagram, you would have seen it on my story because sometimes I do little island updates and tours on there. And this part over here, this little fishing area I made, I love it so much. I've wanted a fishing area on my island since I started, but I've never been able to figure out a way to make a fishing area look lovely. But I really love how it came out in the end. I finally did it. Let me know in the comments, is there any like rituals or traditions you have or things that you do every autumn? Things I really love to do every autumn is I love to go to the bookshop, buy a book, and then go to the coffee shop and order like a mocha. And then sit by the window, read my book, and drink my mocha, and usually I'll get warm food as well. Here in the UK, we have a shop called Greg's that sells like pastries and stuff. I love to just go to Greg's and order a warm pastry, like croissants or something, because it keeps my hands all warm, as well as my mocha. If I get a warm drink, I can walk around and it keeps my hands all warm. I'm so excited for that time of year. Though autumn can get quite gloomy after a while, the same with winter. I think that's why we have celebrations like Halloween and Christmas just to brighten the season up, because especially here in the UK where it hardly ever snows, it's not really a very enjoyable season because it's usually so dark and sad. And especially if you work a 9-to-5 job, you go to work before the sun's even up and then you come home and the sun's already down and you don't get to see the sun like hardly ever. But at the moment it's so sunny still. Wow, that was like a tongue twister. So sunny still. It's still really sunny here in the UK. I think because of global warming, unfortunately. Oh my goodness, no. Quick, we have to run to the museum. Quick, quick, quick. Oh, we made it again. Okay, we're back. I almost got stung by bees twice now, but we made it both times. So lucky. I can't remember what I was talking about. I think I was talking about how it's still sunny here in the UK. Super weird, but I am looking forward to when it's actually cold and we get like rainy days and I can go read a book in the coffee shop or stay at home and snuggle by the window and listen to the rain and read a book or a warm cup of coffee or tea or hot chocolate. I'm so excited for the cozy season. I hope you guys are excited for it too, though I know those of you in the southern hemisphere are just going into spring. I suppose it must be annoying if you live in Australia to experience things like everyone's excited for autumn and you're getting excited for spring. I imagine that must be quite irritating. I'd love to hear if it is or not. I honestly think this game and honestly just the whole world revolves around the northern hemisphere, and the southern hemisphere sometimes just gets left behind, which is really sad. But yeah, if any of you are from the southern hemisphere, I'd love to hear your thoughts on it and let me know what you're getting up to in spring. I'd love to hear about that. So yeah, please don't feel left out if you're in the southern hemisphere. I'd love to hear what you're up to in springtime. And again, if you have any like traditions in springtime. It doesn't look like we're getting any more acorns today. Oh my goodness, this sucks so much. We've got like, what? I think we've got 2 acorns yesterday and we've got 2 today. Am I only able to get 2 a day or something? That's really strange. Oh, do you guys like this area? It's my teddy bear book club area. They're having a teddy bear picnic and reading books together. And there's also a magical musical area behind that, but I won't show you that properly today. Though I've had that on my island for a long time, so you've probably seen that before. Oh my goodness, how cozy is it over here by the campfire? I love the campfire sounds in Animal Crossing. This is so cozy! Oh my goodness. I kind of want to have a different campfire area somewhere else on my island that's not by the ocean, so the campfire sound isn't being drowned out, that we can sit by maybe. And then I can make cute cozy videos by the campfire. That would be so lovely. I really appreciate the sounds in Animal Crossing New Horizons much more when it's 5 a.m. and I can better hear them because the soundtrack is a lot more quieter than the other soundtracks. Like that campfire, I hardly ever notice the sound of the campfire when the regular soundtrack's on, but I used to notice the sound of it all the time in the start of the game soundtrack, and I always notice it more at 5 a.m. as well. I actually really miss that soundtrack from the start of the game. Do you guys ever miss that soundtrack? It's so peaceful and lovely. Okay, I've been playing for an hour now, so let's see how many acorns did we collect. 4. It took me an hour to collect 4. Oh my goodness. That's so bad. Why do I suck so much at finding them? Oh my goodness, they've made it so difficult to find acorns. I've made this whole video looking for acorns and I've been playing for an hour and we've only found 4. Oh well, I suppose we did the best we could. I hope you guys enjoyed walking around with me and my island and collecting acorns anyway. I'll most likely make another one of these videos where we just relax and walk around my island and collect mushrooms once it's November. So I hope you'll look forward to that. I really like this style of video actually. It really reminds me of my pocket camp gameplay where we go around and collect gyrodites and stuff like that. I guess it's basically a chill with me video, which I do know you guys enjoy. A lot of you do come to my channel just to relax. Hope you enjoyed chilling with me at 5 a.m. in New Horizons. I actually really enjoyed this and it was a lot more fun for me to collect acorns while chatting to all of you, so thank you so much for keeping me company. I hope you're having a super cozy and lovely day. Before I go, I do just want to say an extra special thank you to my Patreon supporters for supporting me this month. Your support really helps me out way more than you'll ever realise, and I appreciate you and love you with all my heart. Thank you so, so much for all your support. So, so helpful, and I really appreciate it. And to the rest of you, thank you so much for watching as well. Hope you're having a lovely day. I really appreciate you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please do leave a like and subscribe, only if you want to though. And make sure you let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more videos like these. And that's all for today. So as always, I hope you have a super lovely day. Thank you so much for watching and I'll speak to you in my next video. Bye.